Everyone, I'm Dato Dr. Inder here from Hair Transplant Center at Clinic Dr. Inder. Welcome to my show. Today, my topic for the day in my hair channel is an educational channel. So the topic will be how I personally approach a person, especially a man who walks in into my clinic with hair loss. So basically, the first three goals that I need to achieve when a patient comes in for consultation is number one, of course, introduce myself. Introduce to them that I am Dr. Inder. I'm the American Board of Hair Restoration Diplomat, the only female diplomat of the American Board Hair Restoration in Malaysia. And then tell them a little bit of my background, that how many years that I'm doing the hair restoration, to make them to show some before and after pictures that I have. Okay, all right. So number two, what I need to do is actually build a relationship between the patient and the doctor. So in a very friendly manner, I ask patient what is he doing, what is his hobbies, and then how about his hair loss, what is his feelings, in a very general way, not too much in detail. So sometimes my patients do come in with someone who accompanied them to the clinic. Sometimes the mother, the father, the wife, they come along. So I bring them inside during my consultation so that they're a little bit more comfortable, because hair loss is actually a very sensitive issue. So for someone who's got hair loss, for a first time meeting doctor who's actually a stranger to them, they're not so open up about their feelings. So they're a little bit, don't know what to ask doctor. Many of my patients, you know, when they bring in someone to accompany them, sometimes the person who accompanied them is asking doctor more questions than the patient themselves. So this brings a very nice atmosphere if I bring in the patient or accompanied person together with my patients. So now, number three, the goals now. I have to actually discuss about what is the term short term and long term of the treatment that I have in the clinic. So these are the three goals that I have to do before I proceed with my further consultation in a very, very friendly manner. So the things that I really have to look for, the other things, first of all, is the age of the patient. Because you must remember, I always tell my patients two things that you must know before you leave my clinic. Number one, that in male pattern baldness, you do have a safe donor area. So when doctor extract, harvest and transplant the hair here, that hair, the transplanted hair, does not get affected by the dihydrotestosterone receptor. So meaning to say, they actually stays there and they are permanent solution. They just grow old as you grow old. So that is number one. Number two thing, that doing a hair transplant does not mean that you stop your problem of hair loss is stopped, because you do go into progressive hair loss. So these two things are very important. The principle that they need to know during my consultation, when they leave the clinic, they must understand these two principles. I must make them understand before they can decide what are the treatment that they can do. Because their short-term treatment, they can go on medication for hair loss, they can go on some PRP, paleo-rich plasma treatment, there's some mesotherapy treatments, and then, of course, a little bit of hair restoration called the FUE extraction. So these are the things that I can advise on my patients. So depending on the age is very important, depending on the donor area hair. The donor area hair is the area that we're going to take hair and transplant in front. So the density is very important. So you have to assess the density, and then only you'll be able to know how many grams you can extract. And then you talk about the patient's expectation. You must make them realize that the expectation, you cannot do a procedure of their expectation thinking that they will have hair that they had before. No. So the expectation of patient is very important. Spend some time. I always spend time telling patient what is the expectation that they're going to have after doing the hair restoration, so they are well prepared for it. So, and then the condition of the patient, the condition, like is the patient having high blood pressure, diabetic, all these things have to be asked during the consultation, so we know whether patient is a suitable candidate for what kind of treatment. So, and also another very important history to be taken is the who has hair loss in the family, whether the father's side or the mother's side, because it's hereditary, and how severe is the father. May, for instance, the father has hair loss, what kind of stage the father is having the hair loss, because the patient may follow exactly the same pattern of hair loss like the father. These few things are really important for a hair restoration doctor, because like I said, hair loss is a progressive thing. It's not going to stop by just a short-term medication. So the understanding of the principle of this is very important, so that patient is prepared for the next journey on what he wants to do, whether it's a short term, it's a long term, and then you discuss about the cost of the procedure, what is the maintenance of the procedure. So all these things, after discussion, let the patient go back and decide what exactly the patient wants to do. So they come back and they can ask the second consultation, they can come in to ask for more. So that is all my video today. This is my personal approach for males, not female, because female is slightly different. Thank you so much for watching this video, and happy Diwali to all my followers there.